characters in All the Land to Hold Us came out of the landscape. It's a very harsh landscape with a lot of things missing. There's no water, there's no shade, there's no vegetation. And so these absences of things pulled other things from within the characters. They, not always good things, but this very harsh land pulled things out of everybody and made it stretch far, and sometimes in strange ways. Well, it's a good question. I mean, a lot of writers who traffic in nature writing, for lack of better words, such as I do, at some point in their lives ask themselves, do I prefer the company of wild country to the company of people? It's not necessarily that simple. I love wild country. I love being in it. I love space around me, space around other people. It just feels more natural. I don't think it's an either or situation, but I think for my characters, when they have more space around them, they're able to behave and act more originally rather than in routines and preset, predetermined pathways. I love the differentiation between the word legend and myth. A legend is something that really was long ago, and a myth is something that is more fantastical, could have been, might have been, might yet be. Again, I have a sentence in there that's repeated twice, maybe three times, that a strange and powerful landscape summons strange and powerful occurrences, or something like that. And again, these large, desperate, hungry, very hungry characters come out of a very hungry landscape, a landscape in which nothing is present other than heat and salt, and that's not enough. So it's their direct, as is really every species, their direct functions of their landscape. It's not a place for people, the landscape of this novel, and they try their best to attach and hold on, but it doesn't always work out well for some of them. If you wanted to know about, you know, the American psyche, a book from the 1940s by Robert Penn Warren called All the King's Men, about a politician who started out with a good heart, a man of the people, a populist, who was corrupted by power and had that bottomless hunger and enthusiasm and was extremely dark and extremely light. It's a magnificent novel. It is the great American novel. And it has been for the last, you know, 8 decades or so. And another one, Joe by Larry Brown, and another,